Hello friends, welcome back to Smriti Notes for Biotechnology. In today's video, we will learn about enzymes, its properties, and some more terms like apoenzymes, prosthetic group, coenzyme, holoenzymes, and active sites. So let's start with general characteristics of enzymes. Enzymes are basically biological catalyst, and 99.9% of them are proteinaceous in nature. The term enzyme was coined by F.W. Kuhn in 1878. He also coined the term biological catalyst. Now, enzymes are a little bit different from catalysts due to some of the reasons, like enzymes are biologically produced. They cannot last indefinitely. They are very specific. They also increase the rate of reaction but do not change the equilibrium. Now, the enzymes are of two types, that is intracellular and extracellular. Intra means they are formed inside the cell, and extra means they are secreted by the cells and function outside the cells. They are produced by both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Now, let's have a look at the properties of enzymes. The first one is elementary enzymes. That means they are made up of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, or sulfur. Sometimes they are attached to magnesium, zinc, copper, or iron. Enzymes are amphoteric in nature, that means it acts as both acid and base. Another property is denaturation, that means opening of the conformation. And the other term is degradation, that means breaking into small bonds. Enzymes also helps in formation of antibodies, and they can be complex or simple. Enzymes have catalytic nature, that is turnover number. Number of substrate molecules converted into product per unit time when the enzymes are fully saturated with substrated carbonic anhydrase present in the RBC and has a turnover number of 6 lakh per second. Another property is specificity. Absolute, that means one enzyme, one substrate. Group, certain type of enzymes which show certain specificity. Geometrical, enzymes exhibit specificity towards cis and transformation. Optical means enzymes with reaction with only one of the two optical isomers. Now, next property of enzyme is the thermostability. That means the rate of an enzyme action increases with the rise in temperature. I have drawn the graph showing how the rate of enzyme is increasing with the increase in temperature. An enzyme molecule has an active site, allosteric site, and a substrate which binds to the active site. The allosteric site is the inhibitory site. The enzyme is proteinaceous in nature, as we all know. An active site has amino acids. In every site, they have three amino acids in which substrate is added. All enzymes, a catalyzed reaction takes place within a pocket called the active site. And the molecule that binds to the active site is called the substrate. There are specific amino acids lined on active sites that bind the substrate and catalyze its chemical transformation. I have given the equation. This is enzyme plus substrate gives enzyme substrate, which gives enzyme product, which in turn gives enzyme plus product. The function of a catalyst is to increase the rate of reaction. Another important term is cofactors. Some enzymes require a chemical group for its activity than a protein part. For example, zinc, magnesium, iron, and etc. Cofactors are reusable non-protein molecules that do not contain carbon. Another important term is coenzyme. That is a complex organic or metallic organic group attached to a protein part. Coenzymes are often called as cofactors, but they are chemically different. A coenzyme cannot function alone, but it can be reused several times when paired with an enzyme. An enzyme without a coenzyme is called as apoenzyme. Without coenzymes or cofactors, enzymes cannot catalyze properly. Coenzymes are reusable non-protein molecules that contain carbon. They can bind loosely to an enzyme at the active site. Some examples are vitamins like NAD, FAD, TPP. We will learn about the examples in detail. Another term related to coenzyme is prosthetic group. That means If a coenzyme is very tightly or even covalently bound to the enzyme, it is called as a prosthetic group. And an enzyme attached to the prosthetic group is called as holoenzyme. I have drawn the diagram which shows delta G and delta G naught. Now, a very common example of coenzyme is vitamins, which includes NAD. If vitamin intake is too low, then an organism will not have the coenzyme to catalyze the reaction. Water-soluble vitamins, which include all B-complex vitamins and vitamin C, lead to the production of coenzyme. Two of the most important and widespread vitamin-derived coenzymes are nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide and coenzyme A. NAD is derived from vitamin B3 and functions as one of the most important coenzyme in a cell. When NAD loses an electron, the energy coenzyme called NAD plus is formed. When NAD gains an electron, a high energy coenzyme called NADH is formed. It transfers electrons needed for redox reaction, especially those involved in parts of the citric acid cycle. So this is how coenzyme vitamin NAD basically works. Draw as many diagrams as possible and wherever possible. Now the last one is active site. As the substrate molecules are much smaller than the enzyme molecules, they should have some specific regions on enzymes for binding of substrate. Such attachments are called as active sites, where basically a substrate comes and binds. And the active site occupies relatively small portion of enzyme molecule. So in this video, we studied about properties of enzymes, types of enzymes like apoenzymes, coenzyme, cofactor, holoenzymes, and about their active sites, their prosthetic groups, and holoenzymes. I hope this video is useful for you guys. If you like the video, then do hit the like, share, and subscribe button. Thank you.